Good morning, guys. This is your Sir Dearby again, and welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I'm going to give you 5 helpful tips in order for you to get a little bit stronger and get a little bit further into the campaign. So right now, I'm actually 3 days into the game, and I'm now at the last stage, chapter 10. And I also have made 1 5-star and about to make another 5-star. Okay, so before we go to that, tips on how to make 5-star, let me just give you summoning tips. All right, so by completing the campaign, completing the stages, and completing the story quest, you can get actually a lot of gems. All right, so what you need to take in mind is actually to save some gems, and also make sure you increase the hero list here, because it will easily get full. So make sure you at least have some gems allocated to bags or hero list. Also, you need to increase your bags as well. So at least 1,000 gems will be enough for all of these. Okay, so for the rune equipment material, or not equipment material, for the runes and the equipment, so you need to have some gems for you to be able to increase the limit to that. All right, so for the summoning tip, all you have to do is actually get 1 healer, 1 tank, and that's it. Once you have 1 healer, even if it's only a 3-star or 4-star, that will be good. So for the tank, is actually much better if you start with a 3-star. Why? Because 3-star are easily scalable, and you can easily gain more copy of them. So why we need more copy? That is because we need to increase the skill level up, and in order for you to increase the skill, you need to have a similar copy of what you have. That's the reason why 5-star heroes like this one is it's very hard to level up the skill, because not only you need another SSR copy of that, SSR copy is hard to come by, and you can only get it from special event and the summoning. Alright, so that's the reason why once you're done getting a healer and getting a good tank, well, at least a 3-star tank, then you're good. You're already set. Now, what happened if you have you already have the healer and tank? So what you need to do next is to save premium tickets and to save gems for summoning. Okay, no, not you can also save premium tickets just so you have, you can summon 10. All right, so if you're missing foods, then you can use the premium hero ticket. But if you want to get your hands on a specific hero, then you need to at least have enough gems for you to summon 150 attempts. So whenever you do some summoning, there will be like a discount to it. So at least save 13,000 gems. All right, okay, aside from that, okay, so now you're done selecting your main hero, right? So 1 healer, 1 tank, and the damagers. So let's talk about the damagers. I highly suggest, if you're going to get a damager, if you're FTP, okay, like me, I highly suggest you start with those R heroes. So those R heroes are 3 stars. 3 stars only, okay? So as you can see, one of my R heroes is already 5 star. So what I did is actually farm it out. So this will be my second tip, where to farm fathers and how you can create more 3 stars and more 4 stars for you to create a 5 star. Okay, so for example, I picked this hero, Serena here, Serene, as one of my damagers. She's actually very good assassin type hero, and she has a good AoE. So the reason why I picked Serene is because you can actually get her from the adventure. Alright, so as you can see, there's a summon soulstone here. Okay, my Serene here is 86 out of 90, so I've already farmed 86, so I need 4 more in order for me to summon another Serene. So I actually have or able to farm a complete one before while I'm leveling up my fathers. So there's a guide here, I think it's here. That's not it. Okay, so that star with a point. So all right, so here's the ways on how you can get soul stone for Serene. You can get it from 5-6 and you can get it from 9-6. So I actually prefer to go to 9-6 because not only I can get more copies of soul stones for Serene, I can also level up my fathers. Okay, so for example, here I make sure that I have 3 heroes that can complete the stage, and then I put fathers like this one, the 2 star, and this one. I don't have any other 2 star here, just for example. So yeah, for example, like this one. Let's just say that there's another 2 star here. So while I'm farming or while I'm leveling up these fathers so I can get them to 3 star, I can also get a copy of the soul stone of Serene, and I can also get I'm sorry for that. So you can create more foods for your 3 star or 4 star main hero. Okay, so I have an example here. This one, the Tia, my 4 star healer. So I'm going to evolve her now. So as you can see, my foods here are all normal. Normal hero, that means I already leveled them to level 30 so that I can make them 4 star. Also, since I'm missing one, I will be using this 4 star beanie here. So you can get this 4 star beanie by completing some quests. Completing some quests in the, let's check it out, here in the quest here. All right, so there are a lot of beanies that you can get, and also there are a lot of beanies as well here and this event. Okay, so you need to make sure to check them all, guys. All right, so let's do the evolve or the evolution. Alright, so this will be my second 5 star. Yay! Alright, so now my target is this one, Liu. He will be my next 5 star hero. The reason why I'm prioritizing this is so because of the skill.
Alright, so as you can see, my skill here is already level 4, approaching level 5. That is because Liu is actually pretty easy to get. All of the R hero is pretty easy to get. And just like, for example, this one. I will keep on farming the stage that I showed you earlier in order for me to complete and get more copies of Serene. Alright, so next tip is the adventure and the expedition. Alright, for the expedition, I make sure that I also make some of my 1-star, 2-star, and 3-star hero level up from here. So as you can see, there are a lot of hero EXP reward, and I'm using 10,000, 3,000, and 6,000. So the 6,000, I'm using it for my 3-star father. So these are all normal heroes that I made earlier. Alright, so as you can see, they are all normal. That means they came from 1-star. Okay, so this is the best way, actually, guys, for you to create more 4-stars. So yeah, that's it. Make sure to use this expedition for foods. And the highest EXP giver from here, you can use that for your other teams that you are building. Okay, so for me, I'm using 2 of this 3 out of 3 expedition in order for me to create more fodders for my 4 stars. All right, so last tip. Make sure if you're lost and you don't know what to do, all you need to do is to just click on the story quest here on the above. So this will actually act as a guide for you in order to progress, okay? So there's another guide quest here aside from the story quest. This is on the upper left here, if you can see. Alright, so in the beginner guide, all you need to do is to complete this, and you will have something like a mini goal, alright? And as you can see, I have another goals to complete here. So this will also act as a guide for you. But yeah, this is actually pretty simple. And also, you might find my voice is a little bit funny today, but it's because my asthma is attacking. Alright, so, well, as you can see, the server has reset, and that is 8 a.m. in the Philippines, and I'm not sure what time is it in your area, but it's 8 a.m. in the Philippines for the reset. So I'm at the 4th day, and I have a reward here for 80 action points. So before getting those action point, guys, so this is an additional tip. Make sure you're not near your level up. As you can see on the upper left, there's a bar here, right? So make sure you're not getting those free action point when you're near to level up, because if you level up, for example, you have 70 action point right now, just for example on my end. So if I have 70 action point right now and I haven't used it, and if I level up, it will just go back to 75, where if my action point is low, like I think at least 10 or lower, once I level up, it will fill up the action point max gauge. So it will be like a bonus whenever you level up. So make sure to not always, but keep in mind, or just like to take keep in mind that the action point is filling up whenever you level up, so it's just a good to know, right? So yeah, that's it. And the last tip, actually guys, make sure you have at least one hero per color built. When I say one hero, one damager per color, because as you can see, let me just show you an example. Alright, so as you can see here, stage 1, stage 2, and stage 3, all of them are single color enemy. So just to counter them, make sure to build at least one hero per color. Okay, so you'll have an easier time beating those stages. Alright, so yeah, that's it for today guys. I will give you more tips as I progress more into the game, but right now that's the tips that I can give you. Alright, so if you're new to the game, you can actually look for my guild, and if you want to join, just hit join Mananabas, M-A-N-A-N-A-B-A-S. So it's a Filipino word for Reaper. Okay, so you are all welcome to join my guild, and make sure to if you will be joining the guild, make sure to add me as your friend as well. Alright, and if you want to talk to me about the game, ask for any tips personally, then you can go to my Discord channel. I will put the link on the description below. And yeah, that's it for today guys. Thank you very much for watching, and I'm sorry for the funny voice that I have. That is only because of my asthma. All right, so thank you very much guys. I love you all, and see you on my next video.